Hello everyone, I am Professor Deepika from Sai Vidya Institute of Technology, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering. Today I am here to explain about another experiment, that is testing of rectifier circuit. So before going with the aim of the experiment, let us see what is rectifier circuit. Rectifier circuit is one which converts alternating waveform of energy into a unipolar pulsating DC and which uses diode circuit. We know that diode is nothing but it is a semiconductor device and it conducts only in one direction. So this property of the diode will be utilized in the designing of the rectifier circuit. And we know that rectifier circuits are mainly classified as two types. One is half wave rectifier, the other is called full wave rectifier. So in the half wave rectification, either positive or the negative half of the AC wave will be rectified, or it will be passed to the output, and the other half of the waveform will be blocked. So therefore, the only half of the waveform will be rectified over here. And in the full wave rectifier, both the half cycle or both the polarities, that is the negative positive, or the both the half cycles will be rectified here. And again, in the full wave rectifier, we have two types. One is the center tap rectifier, the other one is called bridge wave rectifier. Compared to the half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier efficiency is more because it converts both the half cycles of the waveform to a DC waveform. And the output of the rectifier, what we will get is, it is not pure DC. As I told you, in the full wave rectifier, the efficiency is more because both the half cycles will be rectified over here. And whatever the output we will get from the rectifier, it is not pure DC. In the definition, as I told you, it is pulsating DC. That means the pulses or ripples will be present in the output. To remove this pulses or to remove this ripple, we will be using the filters. Usually the filters will be consist of capacitors, so the capacitors will be used as a filter so that it removes the pulses and almost the pure form of DC will be obtained at the output. Next we will go to the aim of the experiment. The aim of the experiment is this. It is the testing of rectifier circuits and to determine its ripple factor, regulation and efficiency for full wave center tap rectifier with and without filter. And the second one we have full wave bridge rectifier with and without filter. So this is the aim of the experiment. Now we will go on to the design part of this rectifier. So first one we have center tap rectifier. You can see here, so this is the circuit diagram for the center tap rectifier. The apparatus required here will be, one thing, we will be using the transformer. Its output will be single phase 230 volts, which will be tapping from the main supply. And the output what we are getting here is, it is 12 or 15 volts DC. It's 12 or 15 volts AC again. And this will be given to the diode circuit. So mainly, now I'll be concentrating only on center tapped full wave rectifier. So therefore, I'll be using this type of transformer. Why we call this a center tapped full wave rectifier means because at the secondary side, it has three terminal. It has two high potential terminal and one zero potential terminal. So therefore, if the output is 12 volts, here it will be 12 0 12. If the output is 15, then it will be 15 0 15. So mainly we will be having two types in this lab, and we will be using the two diode circuit. You can see the two diodes will be used over here. From the high potential terminal of the transformer, we will be connecting to the anode of the diode. And the other high potential terminal will be connecting to the anode of the other diode, and the cathode and cathode will be shorted over here. And to actually bypass the current in the circuit to the zero potential or ground potential, we will be connecting the loads or else we call it as resistors at the zero potential end, so that we can observe the waveform at the this terminal. Next, coming to the design of this circuit, we will be designing in this way. That is, we will be considering first one as a ripple factor. What is ripple factor, or the definition indicates that it is the ratio of AC voltage to the DC voltage, and it also indicates how much AC content will be present in the output waveform. Okay, the output is usually DC. In the DC, how much ripple content or AC content will be there? So that will be representing by the ripple factor, and the formula for this is one. Gamma is equals to 1 by 4 root 3 F into RL into C. So here we are assuming gamma is 2.5%, and the capacitor also we are choosing as 100 microfarad, and frequency it will be usually 50 hertz. So we know all these three terms, so therefore we can find out RL. So what is the RL value we will get? It is 1154 ohm. So to get this high value of the resistor, instead of using only the single resistor, in this lab we will follow is, so we will take the combination of two resistor, and these two will be connected in series. So therefore I'll select 100 ohm power resistor, and the other DRB means it is decayed resistance box. Remember that DRB means it is decayed resistance box, because it will be containing the range of the resistances. And this DRB, it is usually of 1 kilo ohm. That means the ranges will be there. In that we will be selecting 1054 ohm or 1 kilo ohm. So this is the thing we are designing. So therefore here the power resistor will be chosen as a range of 100 ohm, and the DRB will be selecting in the range of 1 kilo ohm. The apparatus required in this lab is, that is in this experiment is, one thing we need, a transformer. So you can see here, this is the transformer, and this is the center tap transformer. It will be having three terminal, and the springboards are required for the connection purpose, and these are the CRO probes, and this is the power resistor of 100 ohm, and this is the diode of rating IN4007, and two numbers are required in this experiment. This is decay resistance box. You can see many ranges are there, and these are the connecting wires for the multimeter, and this is the multimeter which is required for the measuring of voltage. And you can see this is the CRO probe where you can see the waveform, output waveform, and you can also measure the voltage over here. Now let us do the connections. Coming to the connections, you can see the transformer secondary part, and we have three terminal. This is 15 volts, 0 volts and 15 volts, and from the 15 volts we will be connecting to the diode. You can see here from the transformer another end will be connecting to the diode, that is anode. We have connected to the anode, then from here this end again it is connected to the anode, and the cathode are shorted. You can see the cathode and cathode are shorted by using another wire. And from this terminal it is connected to the 100 ohm power resistor, and from the other end it will be connecting to the DRB box. You can see here, from here we have connected to the DRB box. So the DRB, the other two terminals of the DRB are connected to this end. Coming to the procedure part, first of all we have to switch on the supply, then we have to check the input to the circuit or output of the transformer. So you can see here the CRO probes are inserted to the two terminal, that is 15 volts and the 0 volts. Okay, so next we will be switching on the CRO. Then we have adjusted the things, and we will be note downing the VM value. Before note downing the VM value, we have to draw the waveform, that is the AC waveform, in our graph sheet. Next we have to note down the VM value. You can see here it is covering almost 1.8 unit. So this 1.8 unit into 10 will be your VM value, that is 1.8 into 10, it is almost 18 volts will be the VM. And also you can note down the time division value or time value. So here also it is covering 1.8, and this will this is also covering 1.8 into 5 millisecond will be the time division. So you can see here I have note down the VM, I have note down the input waveform, and the VM will be how much? It is almost 18 volts. Now let us observe the output, and the CRO probes are connected across the load resistor. You can see here the CRO probes, what you can see, it is connected across the load resistor. Now, in the CRO screen, you can see this is the output waveform you are getting, but the output should be in DC. So, therefore, you have to press this button to get the DC waveform. And again, you can note down the VM value. So, VM value, it is almost again 1.8 units, and that will be multiplied with the 10 volts. So, that is almost again 18 volts. And you can see I have note down the output waveform also. So this is the output waveform of center tapped full wave rectifier without filter. Now to get the performance of this rectifier circuit, we have to calculate or we have to find out the efficiency and percentage voltage regulation. To calculate the percentage voltage regulation and efficiency, we have tabulated these values or these indications. So first of all, we have to calculate the output peak voltage, that is VM. So VM can be calculated by using the CRO, so that you have already noted on. It is almost 18 volts. And VRMS can be calculated by using this formula, which is nothing but VM by root 2. And VDC can be calculated by using this formula, that is 2 VM by pi. Or VDC can also be measured by using the digital multimeter. You can see this is the digital multimeter we are having. So by using this, we can measure the voltage, and you can see here it is connected across the load resistor again. Now we will switch on the multimeter and we will keep it to the VDC value. So you can see this is the VDC value you are getting. It is almost 10.59 volts. Now, VAC can be calculated by using this formula, that is square root of VRMS square minus VDC square. And ripple factor. So, ripple factor gamma is equals to VAC by VDC. You have calculated VAC, VDC, and the ratio will give you the ripple factor. And the efficiency can be calculated by using this formula, that is V square DC divided by V square RMS into 100. And the percent voltage regulation can be calculated by using this formula. You can see it is V no load minus V full load divided by V full load into 100. So this is the percentage regulation formula. So you can see the digital multimeter, whatever the voltage you are getting, it is the V full load value. So it is the full load voltage value you are getting. And to calculate the V no load voltage, you have to remove any one of the terminal of the DRB box. So therefore, I'll be removing one of the terminal, and you can see whatever the voltage you are getting, it is 10.98 volts. So this will be your V no load value. Okay, so that is the 10.98 will be the V no load value. Substitute in this formula, to get the percentage regulation value. Now let us continue with the experiment, that is by using the filter circuit. For this filter circuit, everything that is connection apparatus required remains same, but you have to use the capacitor, which is acting as a filter over here. And this capacitor should be connected across the load resistor and the positive terminal. So you can see here, this is the electrolytic capacitor, you can see, and it is the value of this will be 100 microfarad. The longer lead, what you can see, so this is the positive terminal, and the shorter lead, what you can see, so this is the negative terminal. So therefore, the positive terminal should be connected to the higher potential, that is this side, and the negative terminal should be connected to this side. So please don't remember this, the positive positive should be connected to the higher potential and the negative should be connected to the lower potential. Now let us go with the connection of the circuit. After connecting the capacitor, now we will look at the waveform. So you can see this is the output waveform with filter, but it is not accurate. So to get more accurate value, let us change the this value to the 1 volt. So now you can see the accurate waveform of the this circuit with filter. So here you can measure the VR peak to peak value. So how much it is? It is 1 unit multiplied with 1, it is 1 volt. So 1 volt will be the VR peak to peak value. So this is written over here, it is VR peak to peak value will be 1 volt. Next, VEC can be calculated by using this formula, that is VR peak to peak divided by 4 root 3. Okay, so VAC can be calculated by using this formula. So hence we have calculated VAC, and VDC full load can be calculated by using digital multimeter. It is almost 15.9 volts. So this is your VDC value and VFL value. VRMS can be calculated by this formula, that is square root of VAC square plus VDC square. And ripple factor gamma can be calculated by VAC divided by VDC formula. And percentage efficiency can be calculated by V square DC divided by V square RMS into 100. And the percentage voltage regulation can be again calculated by this formula, that is V no load minus V full load divided by V full load into 100. So V full load you are getting, it is 15.9 volts, and V no load can be calculated by removing any one of the terminal, it is 7.09 volts. So this is your V no load value. This completes the experiment of center tap rectifier with and without filter. In the next session, we will be looking onto the bridge rectifier. Thanks for watching the video.